The Kraft Foods Company presents Willard Waterman as the Great Gildersleeve. The Great Gildersleeve is brought to you, transcribed, by the Kraft Foods Company. Kraft, makers and importers of the world's favorite cheese, now brings you a triumph of cheese making. It's Kraft Natural Swiss Cheese, sliced and sealed by Kraft for your convenience. Natural Swiss cheese is the kind with the holes. Try Kraft Natural Swiss soon. We're sure this new addition to the Kraft family of quality foods will become one of your all-time favorites.
Well, the life of the Great Gildersleeve is very full right now. All day he's busy at the office, and his evenings are taken up with the social obligations of a popular bachelor. He was never one to burn the midnight oil as a schoolboy, but he's burning a lot now with the school principal. That's me.
Just think, Irene. You were in town 2 weeks before I even met you. Now I see you two or three times a week.
You think we should cut it down, Throckmorton?
No need. In fact, I'd like to make up for the 2 weeks I missed.
Oh, I don't want you to get bored with me.
Yeah, that would never happen. Right, George, there's nothing I enjoy so much as what I have right here.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Roaring log fire, cozy room, soft lights, a beautiful girl, and a game of Scrabble.
Oh, when you have soft lights and a fire, there's nothing like Scrabble. Oh, there's nothing like Scrabble with soft lights and a fire.
No, Irene, you know I didn't mean it that way. It just boils down to the fact that I enjoy being with you. Shall we play another game?
Excuse me, Throckmorton.
You bet.
Who could be phoning at this hour?
Say, it is 10:30.
Hello? Oh, hello, Clarence.
Clarence Olson, that pushy hospital intern.
You want to come by tonight?
He wouldn't dare.
Well, it's much too late, Clarence. What's that? Yes, Throckmorton's here. No, he hasn't pitched a tent on my front lawn. You call me again sometime. All right. Bye.
That Olson has his nerve calling at 10:30.
He just got off duty at the hospital.
Yeah?
He wanted me to make him a cup of cocoa.
Well, if he comes by here, I'll send him back to the hospital.
Why, Throckmorton.
Well, I'm tired of that fellow hanging around. If I hadn't been here, I'll bet you'd have had him come by.
Throckmorton, if I wanted Clarence, he'd be here instead of you.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Sorry, Irene.
That's all right. I rather like it when you're a wee bit jealous.
Yeah, then that means you like me best.
You're a very nice man to have around.
Yeah, I am?
Hmm? You're the dependable type. I like that.
Well.
In fact, I think I'll make Dr. Olson's cocoa and let you drink it.
Wonderful.
You'll excuse me. I'll get it started.
Yes, indeed. Jealously, you're just a big, irresistible hunk of TNT. What a fine evening I had with Irene last night. Yeah, I'm late to the office. But I'll make up for it if I can get some cooperation out of Bessie. Ew, what a secretary. Why can't she be like other secretaries and get married so I'd have to hire a new one? Good morning, Bessie.
Good morning, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Well, we have a lot of work to do, Bessie.
Yes, sir.
Did you finish typing the letter I dictated yesterday?
Not quite, sir.
Bessie, have you started the letter?
Well, I started it.
Hey. Oh, my goodness. What have you been doing all morning?
Oh, I haven't been here all morning. I was late, too.
Oh?
Oh, I didn't get here until 9:15.
Well, that's a half hour ago. What have you been doing?
Mr. Gildersleeve, this is one of those days I haven't been able to collect my thoughts.
One of those days. Bessie, where's the morning paper?
I put it on your desk.
Thank you. When you finish the letter, bring it into my office.
Yes, sir. I'll have it ready before you finish the fourth page.
Yes, yes. Bessie doesn't understand that a busy executive has to keep up with what's going on in the world. Let's see what Dick Tracy's doing. Yeah. Why, George, Tracy's wife, Tess, looks a lot like Irene. Yeah, that gumshoe and I know what we're doing every minute. Say, I think I'll give Irene a ring at school. She's probably still in her office.
Miss Henshaw speaking.
Miss Henshaw, this is the water commissioner. How's the pressure out there?
hello, Throckmorton. I didn't expect to hear from you so early this morning.
Well, I thought I'd call. After all, I haven't seen you since last midnight.
How can you stand it?
I bury myself in my work. How about a movie Friday night?
A movie Friday would be lovely.
Fine, it's a date.
Now I'll have to say goodbye. I have a class.
Yeah, I won't keep you. Goodbye, Irene. What a girl. She's always so formal over the phone. But fortunately, after 4:30, school's out. Well, back on the job. Bessie!
I'm not ready.
What a secretary. Ready or not, step into my office.
Yes, sir.
Bessie, what have you been doing? I can't tolerate inefficiency.
I don't blame you, Mr. Gildersleeve. Today, I'm not worth the paper I should be writing on.
What's come over you?
Well, it's about my boyfriend. I'm upset.
Oh?
I found out he isn't taking me to the dance.
To what dance?
Oh, the big Elks Club dance Friday night. You must not read the papers.
Well, I haven't had time this morning.
It's a big charity affair. Look, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Let me see. Oh, yes. Gay holiday season ushered in by Elks Soiree.
Mr. Gildersleeve, I've never been to a soiree.
Well, you're young, Bessie.
I've been dreaming about this party for months.
You have?
Oh, yes, sir. I've worked to save the money to buy my evening gown, and now I won't get to wear it.
Oh, don't you know some other nice young man who'd take you, Bessie?
Do you think it's all right if I ask somebody?
Well, in this day and age, certainly, under the circumstances.
Will you take me, Mr. Gildersleeve?
Me?
Oh, if you take me to that party, I could get my boyfriend back.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Bessie, but Friday night's out of the question.
If my boyfriend could see me with you, he'd be so jealous.
Oh, Bessie. He would?
Because you're so handsome and distinguished looking.
If you think that'll be a help to you.
Oh, yes, sir. And if you'll take me to that party, I'm sure my work will improve around the office.
Bessie, that sold me.
That you, Miss Gildersleeve?
Yes, Bertie.
You home from the office?
Yeah, I believe I am.
Sure you are, because I see you. Hi, Unc, you home?
My boy, what does it look like?
Looks like you're home.
Yes, yes. Bertie.
Yes, sir?
Will you take my tuxedo out of the mothballs and get it in shape for me to wear Friday night?
Yes, sir. Going somewhere, Unc?
Of course I'm going somewhere. Don't be so curious.
Who's curious? Where are you going?
I'm going to the Elks Club's dance.
Hey, you gonna wear your elk's tooth with your tuxedo?
No, Leroy. If I wore an elk's tooth with a tuxedo, I'd look like an idiot.
If you wore two of them, you'd look like a walrus. Oh. Who are you taking, Unc?
Leroy, don't ask your uncle so many questions.
Thank you, Bertie.
He's probably taking Miss Henshaw?
No, I'm not, Bertie.
Miss Tuttle?
No.
Miss May Kelly?
No.
Well, that's the end of the line, Leroy.
As a matter of fact, I have a date with Miss Henshaw for Friday night. But I'm going to ask her to change it so I can do a favor for Bessie.
Yeah?
Mr. Gildersleeve, you taking your secretary to the dance?
Yes, Bertie.
Uh-oh. Boss falls for a secretary. I hope you'll both be very happy.
Now, wait a minute. I only said I was doing her a favor.
Well, isn't that what a guy does when he marries a girl?
Look, Bessie has to go to this party to get her boyfriend back. She's worked and saved to buy her party dress. If she doesn't go, it'll be one of the big disappointments of her life. I'm just being the good Samaritan and taking it.
Oh, that's real nice of you, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Yeah, thank you, Bertie.
Unc, are you going to let Miss Henshaw know you're taking Bessie?
Leroy, you don't tell a girl you're changing a date with her to take out some other girl.
How are you going to explain it to her?
I don't have to explain it. I'll just avoid the subject. Yeah, I better phone her right now.
Well, Bertie's going up to the attic and get the truck seated.
Yeah, good idea, Bertie. Yeah, I'll just tell Irene it's business. After all, it is business, but it'll help Bessie get her mind on her work at the office.
Hello?
Yeah, Irene. This is Throckmorton again.
Yes, Throckmorton.
Yeah, I'm afraid I'll have to ask you to change our date for Friday night.
Oh, working late at the office again?
Well, in a way.
What do you mean, in a way?
Well, I mean, this could easily come under the head of official business. Believe me.
I believe you. Why shouldn't I?
Well, no reason at all.
I'll even phone you at the office Friday night. Just to brighten your evening.
You don't do that.
Why not?
Well, I may not be at the office. But it won't mean I'm not attending to business.
I'm sorry, Throckmorton. I don't mean to be checking up on you. It's perfectly all right if you want to call off our date Friday.
Good. Of course, I'll want one Saturday.
I'll see you Saturday, then. Don't work too hard.
Yeah, I won't. I mean, I will.
Bye.
Goodbye, Irene. Gee, she almost caught me. What I go through for the water department.
Isn't the ballroom beautiful? Oh, and you look so gorgeous in your tuxedo.
Thank you, Bessie. You look very pretty, too, in your new dress.
Thank you, sir. Oh, it's awfully nice of you to bring me. I'm having the most wonderful time.
Good. And remember, Bessie, keep a sharp lookout for your boyfriend.
Oh, I am. Oh, look, Mr. Gildersleeve, at that beautiful dress that girl has on. What did you say?
Nothing, Bessie.
Why, it must have cost $200.
Hey, Bessie, you watch for your boyfriend and I'll watch the girls.
Shall we dance, Mr. Gildersleeve?
Yeah, we may as well. A one, a two. Yeah. We might bump into your boyfriend.
Oh, and if we do, he'll be so jealous. He may run right up and punch you in the nose.
Bessie. Perhaps I shouldn't have come.
I was only teasing. Oh, Mr. Gildersleeve, you dance so well.
Oh, no, I don't.
Yes, you do. Especially for a man your age.
No, Bessie.
Oh, I didn't mean you looked old. You just look sort of settled.
Yes, yes.
And I'll bet everybody here really thinks you're my tall, dark, and handsome boyfriend. And I'm going to let them think it.
Yeah, Bessie, you just keep looking around for your boyfriend.
Oh, I am. Turn me around so I can see the other end of the room.
Yeah, I never could make a left turn dancing. Yeah, I'll turn right.
Oh, we bumped somebody. I lost some sequins.
Sorry, folks.
Clumsy.
Oh, Dr. Olson.
Huh? Oh, it's Gildersleeve.
Throckmorton.
Yeah, Irene. I didn't expect to see you here.
I didn't expect to see you here either.
Well, you know that office work I mentioned.
Yes, nice work. Shall we move on, Clarence? I don't like to disturb a man at work.
Yeah, but Irene...
Gildersleeve, aren't you going to introduce us?
Well, Miss Henshaw, this is Bessie Barstow. Miss Barstow, Dr. Olson.
How do you do?
How do you do, Miss Barstow? It's always nice meeting a girlfriend of Gildersleeve's.
Olson.
I hope you're enjoying the evening, Miss Barstow.
Oh, yes, I am. I was just telling my boyfriend here...
Bessie! These aren't the people you should say that to.
Throckmorton, you're interrupting Miss Barstow.
Well, Bessie's my secretary.
Oh, your secretary.
She is. I'm not Bessie's boyfriend. I'm her boss.
He could be both, couldn't he, Irene?
It's happened before. Shall we move on, Clarence?
Wait a minute, Irene. You don't understand.
Oh, he's only my boyfriend until another boyfriend comes along.
Bessie!
How temporary. Come on, Clarence.
Nice meeting you, Miss Barstow.
It was nice meeting you.
Goodbye, Gildersleeve.
Isn't he handsome?
Over.
What'd you say his name is?
His name is Olson. My name is Mud.
Great Gildersleeve will be back in just a minute. How long has it been since you've had some good, pale, golden, natural Swiss cheese? Natural Swiss, that's the kind with the holes. Well, tomorrow, treat yourself to a package of Kraft Natural Swiss cheese. Natural Swiss that's sliced and sealed by Kraft in convenient packages. This is very special Swiss cheese with heart of the cheese goodness all through it. You see, in the old-fashioned wheels of Natural Swiss, there's a difference between the cheese at the center, or heart of the wheel, and the cheese at the outside edges. The cheese at the center of the wheel has finer flavor and more tender texture. But Kraft Natural Swiss is special. Every bit of it has that wonderful heart of the cheese goodness. Every bit of this Natural Swiss has perfect nut sweet flavor and fine textures. And there's no rind on Kraft Natural Swiss. Kraft slices this cheese and seals it for you in airtight packages. A half pound of this good cheese with the holes to the package. Get a package of Kraft Natural Swiss tomorrow. Make some Natural Swiss and rye bread sandwiches. Or have this cheese with crackers and your favorite cold drink. Enjoy it with fruit for dessert. Whichever way you serve it, you'll be delighted with this new discovery. This fine Natural Swiss with heart of the cheese goodness all through. Kraft Natural Swiss cheese.
See what Mr. Gildersleeve's doing. Sometimes he's too big-hearted for his own good. For instance, now he took a secretary to a dance to make her boyfriend jealous, and the boyfriend never showed up. But Mr. Gildersleeve's girlfriend did.
It was a rough night, huh, Unc?
Rough, my boy.
You must have done a lot of dancing, Mr. Gildersleeve. I noticed your shoes are all scuffed up.
Bertie, that could be because I kicked myself all the way home.
Yes, sir.
I just don't know why these things happen to me.
It's fate, Mr. Gildersleeve. That's what it is, fate.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yes, sir, that's what it is. Pure and simple fate. That's just what it is.
Well, everything would have been all right if I'd told Irene my secretary had a little problem and I was trying to help her work it out.
Oh, you're too cagey for that.
Mr. Gildersleeve's a victim of fate. That's what he is. He's a victim of fate.
Well, I waited for Bessie's boyfriend to show up, and that would have explained everything. But he never did come to the dance.
That's fate. You got no control over that. That's fate.
I never should have agreed to take Bessie in the first place. I was stupid.
That's fate.
Bertie.
Uh-oh, let's go, fate.
Hey, Unc, I just thought of an angle.
Hey, what is it, Leroy?
You took Bessie to the dance, but Miss Henshaw showed up with Dr. Olson. Doesn't that make you even?
Leroy, Irene had a perfect right to make another date after I called ours off.
Well, don't give up, Unc. Why don't you send her some flowers?
I sent her 2 dozen roses, and she sent them back.
Yeah? Why don't you try talking to her on the phone?
I did, and she hung up.
I got one more idea.
What?
Give up.
Well, I think I'll stop in and have a cup of coffee with Peavy. I've thought about this thing until I have a headache. Hello, Peavy.
Yeah, hello, Mr. Gildersleeve. What can I do for you today?
Peavy, I'd like a cup of coffee.
Yeah, well?
Yeah, I have a headache. I better have an aspirin, too.
Yeah,
well. Why, George, I wish I'd married years ago, like you.
How's that?
Well, I wouldn't feel the way I do today.
You think marriage will get rid of a headache, you've got another headache coming.
What?
A married man has a lot more to worry about, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Oh, I don't know, Phoebe. What if your girlfriend wouldn't speak to you?
I don't have a girlfriend.
Well, all right, what if your wife wouldn't speak to you?
Well, there are times when that would be a blessing.
Phoebe, what are you saying?
I'm saying if Mrs. Phoebe wouldn't talk sometimes, it would be a blessing.
No?
I'm thinking of the last time Mrs. Phoebe went to visit her mother. She called up long distance and wouldn't get off the line. Cost me $4.92.
It did?
If she hadn't talked so long, it would have been a blessing.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Mr. Gildersleeve, Mrs. Phoebe and I have been married 35 years. We don't have anything to say to each other that's worth $4.92.
Phoebe, when I come in here, you always give me a lift.
Well, you give me your money. It's a fair exchange. What are you down and out about today?
Well, Bessie asked me to take her to the Elks Club dance to impress her boyfriend. And I broke a date with Irene to do it.
You don't say.
Bessie's boyfriend didn't even show up at the dance. But guess who did?
A lot of elks, I'll bet.
Irene showed up with Dr. Olson.
Your girl in a big mood.
Yeah, Olson takes a great delight in going out with my girls.
Yeah, don't you?
I don't have one to go out with. He has a clear field with Irene now.
Isn't that Dr. Olson crossing the street?
Yeah, looks like he's coming in here. I think I'll go out the back way, Peavy.
Well, you're taking your girl. Are you going to let him chase you out of town?
Good morning, Mr. Peavy.
Well, hello, Dr. Olson.
Oh, and Gildersleeve.
Hello, Olson.
Say, do you spend any time at that water department, or you just float around town all day?
Now, Olson?
Oh, I forgot. You do your work at night, don't you? And with such a charming secretary.
Yes, yes.
I hope you enjoyed the dance last night. I know I did with Irene.
Phoebe, ask him what he wants.
Very well. What can I do for you, Dr. Olson?
Oh, yes. Well, I'd like a box of chocolates, Mr. Peavy.
Any preference?
Gildersleeve, what kind of candy do your girls like?
Olson, one of these days I'm going to cut off your water.
He usually buys the pound box of chocolate-covered cherries.
Now, Peavy...
I'll take a 5-pound box of your best candy, Mr. Peavy.
Yeah, this is the best. You want to charge it?
Yes, unless Gildersleeve wants to pay for it. It's his girl.
What an obnoxious fellow.
Well, I'm not going to say anything against a man who just spent $7.50.
Now he's showering Irene with candy.
Mr. Gildersleeve, does Miss Henshaw understand that you were just trying to help Bessie when you took her to the dance?
She wouldn't listen.
Well, sometimes you have to make a woman listen. If I were you, I'd march Miss Henshaw right down to the office and make Bessie clear up things.
You would?
Women admire caveman tactics sometimes.
Yeah, I suppose they do.
Well, I'm here to tell you, a woman likes to be dominated.
Have you tried this at home, Peavy?
Well, no, I wouldn't say that.
I think I will try some caveman tactics on Irene. What have I got to lose? She's pretty upset. I'd better be ready to stick my foot in the door or she'll slam it in my face.
Oh, it's you.
Irene, I... Oh, my foot!
Well, get it out of my door.
Irene, you might at least let me stick my head inside.
I wouldn't advise that.
Confound it, Irene, you have to listen to me. If you won't let me come in, you're coming out.
Throckmorton, let me go.
No, I'm sorry to be so firm, but this is the only way I know to make you understand things.
For heaven's sakes, if you're going to create a scene, come inside.
Yeah, that's better.
It isn't better, but the school principal can't be seen wrestling with the water commissioner. Honestly, what would people think?
Well, I'm not interested in what other people think. I'm interested in what you think.
You really want me to tell you?
No. Get your hat and coat.
I'll do no such thing.
Yes, you will. You're going to the office with me and let Bessie tell you what happened.
I saw what happened. You broke a date with me and I catch you out with your secretary.
Well, there was a reason for that.
I know. She's very attractive.
Now, Irene, you showed up with Dr. Olson. I could be upset, too.
Well, at least I can depend on Clarence Olson.
You can depend on me, too. And we're going down to my office to prove it.
We are not.
Irene, you come or I'll pick you up and carry you down there.
Throckmorton, you look so fierce.
Oh, I am fierce. Here we go.
Throckmorton, put me down.
I'm not hurting you, am I?
Oh, you man.
Yeah, now, if I can get you out the door.
I've never been carried across the threshold. I always thought I'd be going the other way.
You're too heavy. You'll have to walk.
Oh, wow.
Come into the office, Irene.
All right, all right. Oh,
hello, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Hello, Bessie.
You're awfully late this morning. It's lunchtime.
Bessie, I was forced to go to Miss Henshaw's and bring her here to the office.
Wouldn't she pay your water bill?
I'm paid up, Miss Barstow. I'm fed up, too.
Bessie, tell Miss Henshaw why you asked me to take you to the dance. Now, admit everything.
Everything?
Tell her about your boyfriend.
Well, I had a boyfriend, but he had another engagement last night.
Another engagement?
Yes, sir. To be married.
Oh, my goodness.
I read about it in this morning's paper.
Oh, you poor dear.
It was so nice of you to take me to the dance, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Well, that's all right, Bessie. I'm sorry you no longer have a boyfriend.
Oh, I have another boyfriend now.
You have?
Oh, yes. Here he is to take me to lunch.
Ready, Bessie? Uh-oh.
Dr. Olson, you remember Miss Henshaw and Mr. Gildersleeve?
Clarence.
Hello.
Hello there.
Is that a box of candy for me?
That's not candy. That's a hot potato.
Great Gildersleeve will be with us again in just 30 seconds. Take rye bread and natural Swiss cheese for sandwiches, add your favorite cold drink, and there's a snack. An old favorite snack with special new goodness when you use Kraft natural Swiss cheese. This good pale golden cheese with the holes has heart of a cheese goodness in every bite, and it has no rind. Kraft slices it and seals it airtight in half-pound packages. Get a package tomorrow. Enjoy this wonderful old favorite kind of cheese with a special new goodness, Kraft Natural Swiss Cheese.
Well, this is Gildersleeve again. I guess a lot of our good friends who were busy baking cakes all across the country a short time ago are wondering who won the grand prize in Kraft Oil's Name the Cake contest. So here we are. The Kraft Foods Company congratulates Mrs. Michael Y. Kuchera, 303 Nickel Street, Utica, New York, grand prize winner. Mrs. Kuchera has won a new Ford every year for 5 years for naming our mystery cake baked with Kraft Oil. Congratulations to all winners, and particularly to you, Mrs. Kuchera. See you next week. Good night, folks.
The Great Gildersleeve is played by William Waterman. This is an NBC Radio Network production. The show is written by John Elliott and Andy White and is transcribed. Included in the cast are Walter Tetley, Kathy Lewis, Lillian Randolph, George Dean, Gloria Holliday, and Dick LeGrand. This is a composition by Jack Meekin. This is John Heaston saying goodnight for the Kraft Foods Company, makers of the famous line of Kraft quality food products. Be sure to listen in next week and every week for the further adventures of the Great Gildersleeve.
Done up just right, a delicious hamburger can be truly a gourmet's delight. A big deal in eating pleasure. Of course, just about every good cook knows that a dash of Kraft prepared mustard really makes a hamburger. Because when you add a little mustard, you add a lot of tang. Kraft mustard, naturally. There are two kinds of Kraft prepared mustard. Mild Kraft mustard, if you like it smooth and delicately spiced. Snappy Kraft mustard with horseradish added, if you like it zippy. Get both kinds of Kraft prepared mustard at your food store.
Now play You Bet Your Life with Groucho on the NBC Radio Network. The Kraft Foods Company presents Willard Waterman as the Great Gildersleeve. The Great Gildersleeve is brought to you, transcribed, by the Kraft Foods Company. Kraft, makers and importers of the world's favorite cheese, now brings you a triumph of cheese making. It's Kraft Natural Swiss Cheese, sliced and sealed by Kraft for your convenience. Natural Swiss cheese is the kind with the holes. Try Kraft Natural Swiss soon. We're sure this new addition to the Kraft family of quality foods will become one of your all-time favorites.
See Mr. Gildersleeve coming down the street on his way home from the office. He'll be hungry as usual, and Bertie's going to have everything he likes for dinner. You know why? It's not long till Christmas. I hope Mr. Gildersleeve notices the holly wreath I put on the door.
Hello, Bertie.
Evening, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Say, that's a nice wreath you've got on the door. Looks real Christmassy.
Thank you, sir. Glad you noticed it.
Well, I couldn't miss it with the arrow pointing to it.
No, sir.
I put up the arrow, Unc.
Yeah, hello, Leroy.
Hi. I just wanted everybody around here to know Christmas is coming.
Yeah, I'm well aware of it, my boy.
Oh, here, let me take your hat and coat.
Yeah.
Leroy, you take his hat and I'll take his coat.
Okay.
Such service.
Yes, sir. And I'll brush it off before I hang it up.
Unc, you need a shine. Here, let me brush off your shoes.
If you're so anxious, I'll take them off and you can give them a real shine.
Anything you say, Unc.
I'll run up and get your house slippers, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Don't trouble yourself, Bertie.
No trouble at all. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Bertie can't wait for Santa Claus to come and unload his sleigh. Hey!
Oh, my goodness.
Here's the evening paper, Unc. You can read it while I'm shining your shoes.
Yeah, thank you.
There are some wonderful gift suggestions in the paper this evening.
Maybe I shouldn't read it. I'll just sit here and read the handwriting on the wall.
Have you written your letter to Santa yet, Unc? Mention anything you want within reason.
What's within reason? A dollar?
We want everybody to have just what they want around here, you know.
Yes.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Bert can't wait for Santa Claus. Come on, Christmas Day.
Hey. Bertie, those aren't the words.
They're the best ones I can think of. Here's your slippers, Miss Gilsey.
Thank you, Bertie.
I'm sort of stuck on my letter to Santa, Unc.
Bill?
How do you spell new bicycle?
If you can't spell it, you're not going to get a bicycle. You're going to get a dictionary.
Oh, for corn's sake.
Here's the mail, Miss Gilsey.
Yeah, looks like an invitation to something.
Yeah? Who's it from?
It says, open house at Floyd's Barbershop. Yeah, Floyd always has a few friends in before he closes for the holidays. And here's the first Christmas card. Yeah, the season's greetings from Judge Hooker.
From the judge?
He hasn't been around in a long time.
You come to think of it, he hasn't. I haven't seen the judge since, let's see. When was the last time I saw the old judge?
Anyway, that's the last time you saw him. Don't you want to concentrate on the gift ads in the paper now, Unc?
You wait a minute, Leroy. There's more to Christmas than gifts. Yeah, I'm just beginning to realize that maybe I've neglected the judge. He's a fine man.
Yes, sir, the judge is a fine man. That's one thing you can say for the judge. He's a fine man.
You know, I've been so busy with other things. Social obligations.
You mean girls?
Well, new friends and all. I guess the judge feels I'm slighting him.
Yes, sir, and the judge is a fine man. They don't come no better than Judge Hooker. He's a fine man.
Yeah, I've probably hurt an old friend. This card is probably a gentle reminder that he's still around.
Yeah.
And let's see how he signs it. In the true spirit of friendship and fond recollection, Horace. Good old Horace. I'll bet his glasses fogged up when he wrote that.
Yes, sir. That's a fine man.
You know, I think I'll go out of my way tomorrow to look up Horace. Let him know I haven't forgotten.
Sure. Why don't you take him shopping with you, Unc?
Who said I was going shopping?
I think Leroy's got something there.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell.
Oh, what a conspiracy. I mustn't forget to look up the old judge today. Yeah, I might drop over there this evening if I get my Christmas shopping done. Yeah, I wonder if Peavy has anything new. Hello, Peavy.
Hello, Mr. Gildersleeve. What can I do for you today?
Well, I came to look over your merchandise.
Don't look over it. Look straight at it. I might set a new sales record this year.
Business pretty good, is it?
I'm here to tell you. How's it with you?
You know how it is in the water business. The season doesn't make much difference.
Yeah, I guess it's pretty hard to gift wrap water and sell it for Christmas.
Well, it's never been done, Phoebe.
Well, you could send it in a plastic bag with a rubber card saying, wishing you a watery Christmas.
All right, Phoebe. I'll just look around.
Yeah.
I suppose you've done your Christmas shopping.
Yes, I've found a good place where I can buy it wholesale.
Where, Peavy?
Peavy's Pharmacy.
Yes. Hey, what are you getting Mrs. Peavy this year? Are you just taking something home from the pharmacy?
Oh, no. As a matter of fact, Mrs. Peavy and I put a lot of thought into our gifts.
You do?
I spent a lot of time and money on Mrs. Peavy's this year, and she's going to be very happy.
What are you giving her?
A new furnace.
A furnace?
Yeah, I thought that was a hot idea.
Oh,
yeah, Mrs. Peavy and I like to be practical about our gifts.
What's she giving you?
The coal to burn in it.
That's ridiculous.
Mr. Gildersleeve, are you getting a 2-ton present from anybody?
Well, I hope not. I'd rather end up with a lot of Hawaiian sunset neckties like you and the judge always give me.
You know, I haven't seen the judge since the last Jolly Boys meeting.
You know, I wasn't there that night. Yeah, I haven't seen him in months. Well, I got a Christmas card from him yesterday, Peavy.
You don't say?
Yeah.
I haven't received mine yet. The judge usually drops it by the pharmacy to save the postage.
No, Peavy, let's not say anything against the judge.
No, I'm not saying anything against him.
Yeah, you know, I feel a little guilty about losing touch with Horace. I guess I've grown away from him a little bit.
Well, you've been busy.
Yeah, I've made new friends. I seem to be traveling in another circle.
You've been going around in circles, all right.
All right. The point is, I have to watch it. While I'm forging ahead, I shouldn't leave old friends like the judge by the wayside.
I don't know what the judge is doing these days.
Well, I'm going over this evening to make a duty call. Cheer him up. You want to come along, Peavy?
No, I have to go home to Mrs. Peavy.
Well, she wouldn't care if you stayed out with the boys one night, would she?
No, I wouldn't care that.
The Christmas spirit is a wonderful thing to have, Leroy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can see already that one of the greatest joys I'll have this Christmas is brightening the lonely life of old Judge Hooker.
Miss Gilsey?
Yes, Bertie?
You want me to put some hot rolls in the judge's basket?
That's a nice thought, Bertie.
Yes, sir.
Are you taking him food?
Chicken fricassee, Leroy.
Oh, brother.
Well, it's his favorite dish.
Well, the judge will like this basket after his old cooking.
Yeah. Judge will be glad to see me show up with a basket of goodies.
Why don't you dress up like Little Red Riding Hood?
Leroy, don't jest about a good deed. You should go with me. After all, the judge is your godfather.
Well, he's supposed to look after me. I'm not supposed to look after him.
Leroy.
I'm just kidding, Unc. I'd like to see Judge Hooker. We were always pals. I'll go with you.
That's the spirit.
And you tell the judge if he'd like to have his house cleaned up for the holidays, Bertie would be glad to do it.
Oh, I'll tell him, Bertie.
I sure feel sorry for the judge living all alone like he does.
Yeah, so do I. I should never have given him up for new friends. He probably feels my loss very keenly.
Well, the judge is too proud to ever let you know that.
Yeah. He'd suffer in silence.
No, sir. He wouldn't phone or look you up, poor man.
Yeah. He'd suffer in silence and go his lonely way.
Yes, sir. Just smiling through.
Poor old judge.
Thank you.
it, Unc.
Yeah, I'll take it, Leroy. It was my idea.
Okay. Hey, all the judge's lights are on.
Well, Horace always did a lot of pacing through the house. I should have been over here a long time ago.
Me too. Unc, look, parked in front of the judge's house.
An ambulance. I hope he isn't sick.
That's no ambulance. That's a long limousine with a chauffeur.
Oh, he must be waiting for somebody across the street.
Looks like the judge has painted his house.
Yeah. New doorbell, too.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Hey, a butler.
Won't you come in?
Does Judge Hooker still live here?
Oh, yes, sir. He's expecting you, isn't he?
Well...
Who's that?
Hello, Judge.
Well, Gilday and Leroy.
Hi, Judge.
What a surprise.
Yes, it is, in a way.
Won't you come in a moment?
Is it okay if we do?
Leroy, you're always welcome. Don't stand there, Gilday. Come in.
Well... Yeah, only for a moment.
May I take your hat, sir?
No, thank you. I'll just hold it.
I'll take care of my old friends, Albert.
Yeah, very good, sir.
You have a butler now, Horace?
Oh, he's from the caterers, Gilda. I have him when I entertain.
How about that?
Well, I didn't think you had a regular butler. Nor a car and chauffeur?
Oh, no, that belongs to one of my guests. I'm having a party, Gilda.
Oh, well, then we'd better be on our way.
No, not yet. Come into the parlor. I want you to meet one of the early arrivals. My good friend and client, Mr. W. Roxwell Logan.
Well...
Mr. Logan, this is Mr. Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve.
Yeah, how do you do, Mr. Logan?
How do you do? What did you say your name was?
Gildersleeve.
Oh, I thought everyone knew our water commissioner. And this is his nephew, Leroy.
How do you do, young man?
Hi.
Gildy is one of my oldest and dearest friends, W.R.
W.R.
I suppose I should know you, Commissioner, but I've only recently moved my factory to Summerfield.
Well, I put in the water pipes. You supervised it, I mean.
Of course, I know the mayor. We had lunch at the club the other day.
Hadn't we better go, Unc?
The judge is having a party.
Don't hurry, Gildy. You know most of the guests. I'm introducing W.R. to some of our key people.
Peavy won't be here, will he?
Is he the banker you're expecting, Horace?
No, that's Mr. Robbins. Peavy is one of our mutual friends. Peavy won't be here, Gildy.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Let's go, Unc.
Wait, Gildy. You and Leroy have some hors d'oeuvres. Will you pass them, Albert?
Yeah, very good, sir.
Oh, boy.
Well, I'll have one, thank you. One, Leroy.
Hey, caviar, cheese, shrimp, bacon, and sausages?
What do you have in the basket, Gilda?
Just something I'm taking home to the cat.
The Great Gildersleeve will be back in just a minute. When a man gets hungry for something to eat between meals, he wants that something to be good and hearty, like a nice big sandwich, or maybe his favorite cold drink to go with it. Listening, Mom? Well, surprise that man of yours with Kraft Natural Swiss Cheese for a sandwich that's not only hearty, but exceptionally good-tasting. This cheese with the holes comes without rind, and it's sliced and sealed by Kraft in convenient half-pound packages. What's more... Kraft Natural Swiss has that special heart of the cheese goodness all through it. You see, in the old-fashioned wheels of Natural Swiss, the cheese at the center or heart of the wheel was better tasting and finer textured than the cheese at the outside edges. But as a result of a special process developed by Kraft, this Natural Swiss has heart of the cheese goodness in every single bite. Perfect nut-sweet flavor, fine, tender texture. For your convenience... Kraft Natural Swiss comes without rind. It's sliced and sealed by Kraft, sealed airtight in handy half-pound packages. You'll want this delicious Natural Swiss cheese on hand for all kinds of sandwiches. Kraft Natural Swiss is wonderful with different kinds of crackers, too. And for a delightful change some night, serve this good cheese with your favorite fruit for dessert. Tomorrow, get Kraft Natural Swiss cheese with heart of the cheese goodness all through for your eating pleasure. And sliced and sealed by Kraft for your convenience.
to my uncle, the great Gildersleeve. He couldn't get over the shock when he took lonely old Judge Hooker chicken fricassee and found him eating caviar. The judge was about as lonely as a Santa Claus in a toy department full of kids. I couldn't wait to get down to Mr. Peavy's.
Hello, Peavy.
Hello, Mr. Gildersleeve. What can I do for you?
Peavy, I saw Judge Hooker last night. And you can't imagine the change that's come over the old goat.
Did he shave off his chin whiskers?
No, he just cut off his friends.
You don't say.
When I went over there, guess who answered the door?
Judge Hooker?
A butler. He even looked English.
My, my.
The judge was giving a dinner party.
Did he invite you in?
For one hors d'oeuvre.
That doesn't sound like the judge.
Horace thinks he's flying pretty high, Petey. Yeah, I shouldn't have bothered to look him up again.
Yeah, I take it you haven't been missed.
Yeah, I'll say not. He's hobnobbing with bigwigs.
Hmm. Who would have thought it?
He told me he's spending his time with key people. And that doesn't include me, the water commissioner.
Well, the only thing you have a key to is your pump house.
It wouldn't have hurt the judge to invite me to his party.
Mr. Gildersleeve, you eat a lot of hors d'oeuvres when you get the chance.
He doesn't have to be ashamed of me in front of his big shot pals.
You know, the judge never high-hatted me.
Oh? Have you ever met W. Roxwell Logan, the shoe manufacturer?
Yes, I sold him some arch preservers last week.
Oh. You're just sticking up for the judge.
Well, I have no reason to run him down.
Well, I'll tell you something. I'm dropping him.
Don't tell me, tell him.
What?
Here he comes.
You know, I don't want him to see me. I'm going to hide behind the counter. Get rid of him in a hurry.
Hello, Peavy.
Hello, John.
How's my old friend?
Very well, thank you.
Old friend.
I had your Christmas card ready for several days, but I wanted to see you personally, so I thought I'd drop it by.
What a way to save 3 cents.
Well, that was very thoughtful of you, John.
You may open it and read it while I'm here.
Very well.
I can't stay wedged into this counter long.
Let's see what we have here. In the true spirit of friendship and fond recollection, Horace.
That's exactly what he wrote to me.
Yeah, that's very nice, Judge.
Not at all. I've missed seeing you, Peavy, and I hate to dash today, but I imagine you're busy, too.
Yeah, good, he's going.
No, I have anything to do, and if you'd care to stay and chew the fat for a little while...
I'd be delighted.
I guess you haven't seen anything of Mr. Gildersleeve lately, have you, Judge?
Oh, I meant to tell you, Peavy. Gildy dropped by the house last night.
He did?
I haven't gotten around to seeing Gildy for some time, and he looked a little friendless.
Oop. Is that a fact? Did you, notice anything else about him?
Well, he seemed to be ill at ease. I'm afraid that he feels I've slighted him.
No, just a minute, Judge.
Is that you, Gildy?
Yes, it is.
Or is it a bull in a china shop?
What's this about slighting me?
Well, I felt that...
How have you know I'm the one who's slighting you?
Gildy, I'm surprised at you.
Well, I'm surprised at you, too. Don't consider me a key man in Summerfield, huh?
If you're upset because I didn't invite you to my party, old friend...
Don't old friend me.
I might remind you that I haven't received any engraved invitations to your house.
They won't either.
I won't expect it.
No, gentlemen.
Looking back, I can see where you've avoided me.
Well, looking ahead, you can see where I'll keep on doing.
Don't you speak to me like that.
Will you gentlemen step back away from the showcases?
I don't intend to speak to you at all. You stuck-up old goat.
Gildy.
Social climber.
Water peddler.
Judge, don't start something.
You started it, didn't he, Peavy?
Now, don't get me in this. I'm just your friendly neighborhood target.
You didn't eat much, Mr. Gildersleeve. Didn't you enjoy your dinner?
There's nothing wrong with your fine dinner, Bertie.
Pass Unc's dessert to me, Bertie.
Leroy, you've eaten enough. Hands off.
Oh, gosh, what did I do? And here I've been trying to stay out of trouble till after Christmas.
That's right, Leroy. Now, why don't we all just try to have the Christmas spirit?
The judge has destroyed the Christmas spirit in me.
You mean no bike?
I have a notion not even to buy a tree.
Well, you hardly ever do. Judge Hooker usually brings one over.
He better not show up with one this year. I'll chase him right up it.
The judge is all right, Unc. I thought he was real nice to us the other night.
Leroy, stop defending Judge Hooker in my presence.
Oh, gosh.
Leroy.
I always considered the judge a fine man.
Bertie?
Yes, sir.
He's a turncoat friend, a no-good lawyer, and a do-nothing judge.
Yes, sir. That's a fine man.
You want to see me, Leroy?
Yeah, Mr. Peavy. I want to talk to you about Unc.
Very well.
Now, you wouldn't believe this, but Unc and the judge aren't speaking to each other.
No, I believe it.
And that's not all. Unc says he won't even allow the judge on the property this Christmas.
You don't say.
Gosh, it won't seem like Christmas without the judge coming around.
He has been a regular at your house, hasn't he?
Yeah. Ever since I was a little kid. One year, he was even Santa Claus.
The judge?
He was a skinny one, but he was the best we had. On Christmas Day, we'd all gather around the piano and sing.
And I don't think you'll miss the judge there.
Well, I will. And so will Unc. He just won't admit it.
Men can be pretty stubborn at times, Leroy.
But Unc needs his friends. He's no good without them. He's grouchy and touchy as an old bear.
No, I hate to see a couple of jolly boys at odds during the holidays. You run along, Leroy, and I'll see what I can do.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Peavy.
And you better take this candy bar. It might make you feel better.
Thanks. And, Mr. Peavy?
Yes?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Leroy. Well, I said I was going to keep out of this thing, but here goes. I want them to get it together again, but I don't want them together in my pharmacy.
Gildersleeve speaking.
Mr. Gildersleeve, this is Mr. Peavy.
Oh, hello, Peavy.
I'm calling to let you know there's a special Jolly Boys meeting tonight.
Well, I won't be there. As long as the judge is a member, I'm out.
Well, that's why the meeting. We're going to drum the old goat out of the club.
What?
Took me a while to realize how right you are about the judge.
Peavy, what's the judge going to say about this?
Mr. Gildersleeve, all the jolly boys won't be there.
You're pretty cagey, Peavy.
That's what I say. Can I count on you?
Well, if you think it's the thing to do, before Christmas.
Now, I'm here to tell you, like you say, he's a stuck-up turncoat. Be there at 8 o'clock.
Yeah, all right, Peavy, I guess he's asked for this.
Anybody he's asked for is going to get it.
Goodbye, Peavy.
Goodbye. This might turn out to be fun.
Judge Hooker speaking.
Judge, this is Mr. Peavy.
Well, hello, Peavy.
I thought you might like to attend a special Jolly Boys meeting tonight.
I can't make it. I'd rather not see Gildy.
Judge, all the members won't be there.
Oh?
We can do without a certain big blowhard. Catch on, Judge?
Yes, I do.
I've been thinking over some of the things you said about a certain city official, and perhaps we should just tell him to go peddle his water.
You mean blackball, Gildy?
Well, do you have any other suggestions for getting rid of him that are legal?
Well, it is the Yuletide season.
Now, don't get sentimental, Judge. Are you coming to the meeting or not?
I'll be there.
Yeah, there's a light on upstairs. Some of the jolly boys are here already. I don't hear any singing. Well, when you're blackballing somebody, it's no time to sing.
Is that you, Peavy?
Hello. Something went haywire.
Who is it?
Nosy old judge. You can't even keep him away from the meeting you're throwing him out of.
Gildy, what are you doing here?
You're the one who isn't supposed to be here, Hooker.
Peavy told me confidentially that you wouldn't be here or I wouldn't have come.
Well, I wouldn't be here if I'd known you were going to be here. I've been double-crossed.
As far as I'm concerned, the meeting is over.
Yeah, I don't think there's going to be a meeting or some of the fellows would be here.
There's something strange going on because here's a Christmas package addressed to you and me.
Oh?
And we're sworn enemies.
I'll say we are. You think we should open it?
I'll open it. My name's on the card first.
Pushy, you're too late, Judge.
Gildy.
Say, a pair of boxing gloves.
Two pair.
Oh, here's a note from Peavy.
What does he say?
He says, fellow jolly boys, instead of blackballing each other, give each other black eyes. Shake hands and come out fighting.
Well, of all the... Good old Peavy.
Yeah. Let's stop the fighting and just shake hands, Judge.
I'm so happy I could just burst into song. Oh, how I've missed you,
Judge.
Dear old man.
Judge, can we just shake hands and be friends? The great Gildersleeve will be with us again in just 30 seconds. There's a delicious treat in store for you folks who go for that good cheese with the holes, natural Swiss cheese. This treat is Kraft Natural Swiss Cheese. Because of a special process developed by Kraft, this natural Swiss has heart of the cheese goodness in every bite and no rind. Kraft Natural Swiss is sliced and sealed airtight in half-pound packages. Enjoy this fine-tasting pale golden cheese often in all kinds of snacks and sandwiches. Tomorrow, get Kraft Natural Swiss Cheese.
Finished the rest of your Christmas cards yet, Unc?
Well, all but putting on the Christmas seals, Leroy. As a matter of fact, you might help me with that.
Oh, sure. Hey, you've got twice as many seals this year.
Well, buying Christmas seals is one of the most important things you can do at Christmas.
Yeah?
By buying Christmas seals, you're helping the National Tuberculosis Association to help a lot of people.
Yeah, I know. I got a motto for them.
You have?
Yeah. A Christmas seal is a good deal.
It's very good, my boy.
Unc, by the way, did you write a lot of flowery stuff on your cards like Judge Hooker?
Of course not, Leroy.
How about this one to Miss Henshaw?
Young man.
The very best Christmas present I know is to catch you under the mistletoe.
Leroy. Good night, folks.
Gildersleeve is played by Willard Waterman and is an NBC Radio Network production. The show is written by John Elliott and Andy White and is transcribed. Included in the cast are Walter Tetley, Earl Ross, Lillian Randolph, Paul Maxey, Dick Ryan, and Dick LeGrand. Musical compositions by Jack Meekin. This is John Heaston saying goodnight for the Kraft Foods Company, makers of the famous line of Kraft quality food products. Be sure to listen in next week and every week for the further adventures of the Great Gildersleeve.
What goes into your favorite sandwich? Maybe it's roast beef or savory baked ham. Whatever your favorite, the perfect meat sandwich needs the perfect mustard. Kraft prepared mustard. For when you add a little mustard, you add a lot of tang. You can take your choice of two kinds of Kraft mustard. Mild Kraft mustard is smooth and delicately spiced. Or if you like your mustard with extra pep, try Kraft mustard with snappy horseradish added. Keep them both on hand and keep everyone in the family happy. Next time, get Kraft prepared mustard.
The holiday season from Christmas to New Year's is an especially deadly period so far as traffic accidents are concerned. The toll of traffic fatalities rises sharply every year during this period. Please take extra precautions in walking and driving. Don't let death take your holiday. Now play You Bet Your Life with Groucho on the NBC Radio Network. The Kraft Foods Company, makers of parquet margarine, presents Willard Waterman as the Great Gildersleeve. The Great Gildersleeve is brought to you, transcribed, by the Kraft Foods Company. During the year now drawing to a close, we have appreciated the confidence you have shown through your purchases in all the fine food products which your grocer has brought to you from Kraft. You may be sure that Kraft products will continue to merit your confidence in the future as they have in the past, and that the name Kraft on any label will continue to be your guide to the very finest in foods.
Imagine, tomorrow night's Christmas Eve. Boy, am I ready for it. My Unc's about ready, too. He's the great Gildersleeve. Unc's a great guy. He'll do anything for you if he likes you. Next to me, I guess he likes Miss Irene Henshaw best. You should have seen him when I came home from school last week and told him what she was planning with his rival, Dr. Olson.
Hello, Leroy.
Hi, Unc.
That you, Uncle Leroy?
Yeah, hi, Bertie.
I thought that was you. Dinner'll be ready in just a few minutes.
You're late, my boy.
I wanted to give you time to hide any new presents you may have for me.
What makes you think I have any presents?
What makes you keep your room door locked this week?
Well, to tell you the truth, I've got Santa Claus locked up in there. I want to be sure he stops here first.
Yes, sir?
Is he in that big red box in the corner, or is he under your bed with all those other packages?
Young man, how do you know what's in my room?
I shinnied up the big tree by your window and looked in.
Leroy.
Leroy and I are really looking forward to Christmas, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Did you shinny up the tree too, Bertie?
No, sir, not me. I don't know what's in that room. I can't even get in there with the vacuum cleaner.
Well, the room will be cleaned out after Christmas. And so will I.
Yes.
Hey, Aunt, guess what your girl is going to do at school?
Yeah, I don't know. And I'll thank you not to refer to Miss Henshaw as my girl.
Okay. Sweetie?
Leroy. She's your school principal.
Okay, okay.
Well, what's she going to do, Leroy?
She's going to have a tree in the gymnasium with presents for all the needy kids in town.
Oh?
That's nice.
Yeah, some of us kids are going to help collect presents.
You know, I tried to get Irene on the phone all day. Figured she was busy with something.
Yeah, she and Dr. Olson have been busy, all right.
Dr. Olson?
He's been huddling with her all day.
Uh-oh.
What does that pushy intern have to do with it?
Oh, he just offered to help her arrange everything. She has to rustle up a lot of gifts somehow.
Well, the only reason Olson is helping is to be near my girl. Yeah, I mean, Miss Henshaw.
Dr. Olson's a nice guy, Unc.
Yes, yes.
Leroy, you can't sell that to Mr. Gildersleeve.
No, indeed. Olson isn't doing this just because it's Christmas. He's catering to Irene. Just trying to cut me out.
Are you jealous, Unc?
Most certainly not. But what does Clarence Olson know about organizing a thing like this? He's not a businessman. He's just an intern studying to be a surgeon.
He's got this operation sewed up.
Well, I wouldn't stoop to such obvious tactics.
Oh, no, sir.
But maybe I should go over to Irene's this evening and offer to help before Olson bungles it.
Yes, sir. I think you should get into a huddle with it, too.
Bertie and Leroy thought I was a little jealous of that curly-haired intern. Well, maybe I am.
Hello, Throckmorton. Come in.
Thank you, Irene.
Let me take your hat and coat.
I'll just put them right here in the chair. That way, you and I'll have to sit on the couch.
Oh, you're quite a schemer, aren't you?
You bet. Yeah. I tried to get you on the phone today.
Oh?
Leroy tells me you're having a big Christmas party for the kids.
Yes, I thought it might be nice.
Yeah, I'm a little hurt because you didn't ask me to help.
I'm sorry, Throckmorton. Clarence Olson volunteered first, and I know you're a beau who doesn't like to play second fiddle.
Of course, I don't want to say anything against Olson, but this is a job for a businessman.
Yes, I realize it'll take a lot of doing. He wants to come over tonight and make plans.
Yeah, I know what his plan is. Besides, I'm here first.
Well, Throckmorton, we need all the help we can get. We have to decorate the tree, collect toys to put under it. Some of them will have to be mended and painted.
Yeah, that must have been Olson's idea.
No, it's mine.
Well, that Olson's such a sneaky character, he probably made you think it was your idea.
Throckmorton, Clarence never talks about you.
He doesn't?
In fact, he never mentions your name.
That's the worst thing he could say about me.
Well, how would you stage this Christmas party and provide the toys?
Me?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'd organize the thing. I'd get some money behind it.
Whose?
Well, I've been thinking about that. With my influence, I could put the Jolly Boys Club behind this project.
Oh?
The city has a vacant lot we can use. We'll sell Christmas trees and buy presents with the profits.
Well, I hadn't thought of selling trees.
Say, Irene, the Kraft Choristers are in town for a concert. Yeah, I'll bet I can get them to come out and sing a couple of songs.
Oh, that would be wonderful.
Yeah, there's a way of doing these things, Irene, if you just come to the right party. Just imagine rows of trees, people flocking in to buy them.
Oh, Throckmorton, you've got me buying the toys already.
Yeah, and we'll have mistletoe for sale. Plenty of mistletoe.
Yes. If I know you, you'll have mistletoe.
You bet. Just imagine I'm holding some over your head right now.
Well, I have a good imagination.
No. I love Christmas. Right, George, I sure made a hit with Irene. She likes an executive-type fellow who gets things done. Well, I better stop in Peavy's and start telling the Jolly Boys the plans I've made for them. I'll have to assign them certain days to work on the lot. Hello, Peavy.
Yeah, hello, Mr. Gildersleeve. What can I do for you?
Peavy, I want to talk to you.
If all you want to do is talk, I'll just keep on with what I'm doing.
So I was just talking to Irene Henshaw.
6 and 2 are 8 and 3 are 11.
Peavy, what are you doing?
I'm making out my bank deposit slip. 3, 7, and 10.
Can't that wait?
Mr. Gildersleeve, do you want to buy something?
No.
I'm dealing with people who have bought something. 14 and 3 make 17, $187.
Peavy, listen to me. That isn't important.
Do you have anything to say that's worth $187?
Oh, my goodness. Look, I have a great idea.
You don't say.
Yes, indeed. The Jolly Boys are going to sell Christmas trees to raise money.
We can use it. We've got $2.69 in the treasury.
Peavy, we're going to spend this money on the kids.
Suits me. I'm a bigger kid as anybody around Christmas time.
Yes, yes.
I got the Christmas spirit this morning. Before I left for the pharmacy, I chucked Mrs. Peavy under the chin. She said I was a big, overgrown kid.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, here's Chief Gates.
Hello, Peavy.
Hello, Chief.
Chief Gates, just the man I want to see.
Not many people want to see the chief of police. Ho, ho, ho.
Well, I do.
Just because it's Christmas, I'm not tearing up any parking tickets.
No, I don't want any favors. I just want you to sell some Christmas trees for me. I've taken on a little project for the Jolly Boys.
Well, this is news to me.
Yeah, it was to me, too, and I'm president of the club.
Now, don't be offended because I come up with the good ideas. I promised Miss Henshaw we'd sell trees to buy presents for her Christmas party.
Why, I'm not invited to her party.
No, it's for needy kids, Chief.
Oh, count me in.
Fine. Now, I know where to get a truckload of trees. We'll put them on that city lot on the corner of 4th and Main.
That should be a busy corner around Christmas. It's right across the street from the loan company.
All right. I'll have the trees there tomorrow, and we Jolly Boys will be on hand to sell them.
Oh, I have to run the pharmacy, Mr. Gildersleeve. Of course, I could slip over for a little while after I close at night.
Look, Peavy, I'm going to make arrangements to be there.
Yeah, but you don't have anything to do. You have a political job.
What about you, Chief?
I can't run off and leave nobody at jail but the prisoners. Those fellows get lonesome.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, let's not forget it's Christmas. Those fellows are away from home.
You're all right.
I'll drop over when I can. What about the judge?
You know, he's trying a case in Center City this week.
What about Floyd Munson?
Well, Floyd's got a barbershop to run, but I'm sure he'll help out at night.
And I'll be there right after the prisoners go to sleep.
Oh, fine. Looks like none of you fellows can come over until all the customers have gone to bed.
I'm sorry, Commissioner.
Yes, we're willing. But I understood Dr. Olson was going to help Miss Henshaw with the party.
Peavy, you know Irene would rather I take the initiative than Dr. Olson.
Well, no, I wouldn't say that.
You got a swell location for selling trees, Unc.
Yeah, let's set up some more, Leroy. You hold this tree while I nail on the stand.
Why don't you hold the tree while I nail it on the stand?
Oh, no. You've hit my thumb 3 times.
Well, that shows I need the practice. Hey.
Just hold the tree.
Okay.
Yeah, that does it.
Well, that's enough trees, Unc. You haven't sold a one.
Yeah, they'll start moving after the Kraft choristers come out here and sing a couple of carols.
You're really coming, huh?
Yeah. We'll have to get these lights strung around before they show up.
Hello?
Well, hello, Irene.
Hi, Miss Henshaw.
Hello, Leroy. I thought I'd come over to see how many trees you sold.
Tell her, Unc.
Yeah, well, you were just getting set up. I'm having to do this single-handed.
Oh, what happened to the Jolly Boys?
Well, they can't give as much time to it as I'm getting.
This is a fine thing you're doing for those children.
Yeah.
He's not doing it for the kids. He's doing it for you.
Young man, string the lights.
Sure. Hey, there's the Kraft bus.
Oh, you are going to have carols.
You bet.
Hey, look at all the people.
Throckmorton, you're a genius.
Well, I'll do until a genius comes along.
Mr. Gildersleeve?
Oh, hello, Mr. Heaston. This is Miss Henshaw. She's sponsoring the Christmas party.
How do you do, Miss Henshaw?
How do you do? It was nice of you and the group to come, Mr. Heaston.
Oh, it's our pleasure. We'll be ready to go in a moment, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Great. Fire when ready.
Hey, Unc.
Yes, Leroy?
Do you suppose they'd mind if I went over and stood with them and helped them sing?
Leroy, we're trying to attract people, not frighten them away.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Shh. He's going to make an announcement, I think.
We are happy to present the Kraft Choristers under the direction of Gerhard Schroth. Their first selection will be It Came Upon a Midnight Clear.
Pretty good. All Kraft employees, too.
Well, we're attracting a crowd, all right.
Yeah, I'll say. He said they'd sing a couple of numbers, and then we'll start selling treats.
And now we invite you to listen to Ding Dong Bell.
Should I try to sell some trees while they're singing?
Shh, listen, Leroy.
Ding Dong Bell, Ding Dong Bell.
Oh,
customers, Throckmorton.
Heck, I'm going to start selling Christmas trees. Right this way for your Christmas trees.
Yeah, look at them pick out their trees. Why, George, the old world seems pretty uncooperative at times. But when you try to do something good, a lot of people get behind you.
Christmas is always a memorable time for everyone, and especially for the great man, Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve. He's been helping Miss Irene Henshaw with plans for her Christmas party for needy children. As school principal, Miss Henshaw makes quite a point of giving credit where credit is due, and she isn't forgetting the great Gildersleeve's contribution, because he won't let her.
What'd I tell you, Irene? I knew I'd put this thing over big. Didn't I tell you?
You told me.
Hey, look on the lot here. We're practically sold out of Christmas trees the first day. I told you we didn't need that Clarence Olson.
You told me.
Well, while there's a lull, let's count all the money we've taken in.
I've already counted it. I got my pockets full of it.
Leroy, I will carry the money.
Oh, sure.
Hello, everybody.
Hi, Dr. Olson.
Clarence, I've been wondering what happened to you.
Hello, Olson.
I got tied up at the hospital, Irene.
What'd you do, bandage yourself to a bed?
Well, you aren't glad to see me, are you, Throckmorton?
We've managed to get along without you. Just look at the money we've taken in for Irene's party.
We've done surprisingly well, Clarence.
Yes, it surprises me, too, Irene, especially with him in charge.
Watch it, Olson.
Give me the bankroll, Gildersleeve. I'll go buy presents for all the kids.
You keep your sterilized pinkies off my money.
All right. You buy the gifts, and I'll present them at the tree.
You'll present them?
Well, I was to play Santa Claus, wasn't I, Irene?
Well...
Look, Olson, I'll be Santa Claus.
But, Gildersleeve, you've done so much. You told us that yourself.
You bet. And after I've knocked the home run, you aren't going to pose for the picture.
Now, please, boys...
I volunteered to help Irene raise money for her Christmas party long before you and the Jolly Boys came in.
Well, when I came in, you went out.
I won't argue with you, but I'll be Santa Claus.
Oh, for...
Hey, Unc, I sold another tree.
Hey, good for you, my boy.
Wonderful, Leroy.
Yeah. Unc, hadn't we better connect the lights?
Well, I haven't quite figured out how to attach the wires to the switch.
Oh, I'll do that, Gildersleeve. I undoubtedly understand wiring better than you.
Shouldn't you call an electrician?
No, Irene, I can do it.
Hands off, Olson, I'll do it.
Well, I wouldn't do it while standing in that slushy snow.
When I need advice from you...
The Christmas tree lot's a big success, Bertie.
I sure am glad.
Well, it was planning, organization, know-how.
Yes, sir.
Speaking of know-how, you should have seen Unc when he tried to connect the lights on the lot.
Don't tell me they wouldn't light up.
No, but Unc did.
Well, I was just nervous. That Olson breathing down my neck, telling me how to do this, how to do that, trying to cop the credit. He even wants to be Santa Claus, Bertie.
Yes, sir.
Who's it going to be, Unc? You or Dr. Olson?
I know who's going to be Santa Claus, Leroy. I may as well go up in the attic right now and get out his suit, because I know who's going to be Santa Claus.
Yeah, good idea, Bertie. You know, that pushy intern did ask Irene first.
I don't know who asked first, but I know who's going to be Santa Claus.
Yeah, well, Bertie...
I don't know what's wrapped up in them packages, and I don't know what's under the tree, and I don't know what's in the stocking, but I know who's going to be Santa Claus.
You think I should, Bertie?
I don't know who should, but I know who is, so I'm going up in the attic and get the suit.
Well, as long as Bertie insists on getting the suit, I'm going to insist on wearing it. To do this is to get the Jolly Boys to back me up. After all, it has become a Jolly Boys project. Olson has nothing to do with it. Hello, Peavy.
Hello, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Hello, Chief.
Hello, Commissioner. We were over at the lot last night, but there were no trees left to sell.
Well, I did a good job, if I do say so myself.
What's the meeting about, Mr. Gildersleeve?
As you fellas know, I took this out of Olson's hands and raised the money for the guests myself. Now, guess who wants to be Santa Claus?
You?
Well, why shouldn't I? I made it a Jolly Boys project. Now, I sold the trees. Why shouldn't I pass out the presents?
Oh, you've done too much, Mr. Gildersleeve. I think it's time I got on the job.
What do you mean?
I'd like to donate my services and be Santa Claus.
Peavy, you don't look like a Santa Claus.
I do to Mrs. Peavy. She considered me a very convincing Santa Claus.
Well, she's prejudiced. You're not big enough for Santa Claus.
Well, I can tie on a couple of pillows. I'd rather wear them at Christmas than to have to carry them around all year like you do.
Now, wait a minute, fellas. Why don't we arbitrate this thing? I'll be Santa Claus.
Chief, that's not the way you arbitrate.
But Santa's supposed to be a jolly fellow. I've got the voice for it.
Oh, brother.
Chief, you sound like a walrus lost in the fog.
Well, if the chief of police can't play Santa Claus to those kids, you fellas better not run afoul of the law next year.
No, fiddlesticks. Let's not have a Santa Claus if it's going to cause an uproar.
No Santa Claus?
I think Peavy has a good idea.
Well, all right, all right. I'll call Olson and tell him we've all agreed not to have a Santa Claus. What do you say, fellows?
In the interest of harmony, no Santa Claus.
No Santa Claus.
No Santa Claus. They don't know I have my fingers crossed. Yeah, I'll slip in the back door of the gym so nobody will see me.
Is that you, Unc?
Yep, old Santa in person.
Santa.
Well, I couldn't disappoint a bunch of kids just because we adults had a squabble. Leroy, how did you know me in this Santa suit?
You're the only knock-kneed Santa in town.
Young man.
Only kidding.
Has Irene shown up?
Yeah, she's inside arranging the presents under the tree.
She'll be surprised.
Yeah. Miss Henshaw, look what the reindeer's brought.
Why, Throckmorton.
Hello, Irene.
Aren't you cheating a little on the boys?
Well, as I told Leroy.
Greetings from the North Pole.
Hey, another Santa.
Why, Clarence Olson.
Olson, that's a sneaky trick.
That you behind that beard, Gildersleeve? I thought it was Father Time.
Yes, yes. What a snide Santa Claus.
What is this, a convention? Here comes two more.
Hello, Miss Henshaw.
That sounds like Chief Gates.
Ho, 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 ho. I bet you don't know who I am.
Why, Mr. Peavy.
Peavy, I thought you fellas weren't going to dress up like Santa Claus.
Well,
look at you, Mr. Gildersleeve.
I'm really the only one who has any business in costume. I volunteered first.
Gentlemen, this is ridiculous.
Yeah, your suits don't fit. And all of you look like a bunch of phonies.
That's just what they're being, Leroy. Phonies.
What's that?
Before I say anything else, I want to thank you. for all you've done to help me. But somewhere along the line, we've kind of lost sight of the goal.
Yeah, but Irene...
Now, we started out to provide a good Christmas for needy children. Not to satisfy your inflated egos.
Well, Irene...
Why don't you listen?
The children are waiting to come in. So I want you men to take off those silly suits, roll up your sleeves, and pass out the packages. It isn't the suit and funny whiskers that make the Christmas spirit. It's what's inside.
By George, she's right. Hey, Olson?
Yes, yeah, she's right.
And Mrs. Peavy didn't really like me in this suit anyway.
Well, I guess I'm the biggest offender. I was so anxious for the kids to know what I'm doing, I wore them a badge on the outside of my Santa suit.
Hey, Unc, before the kids come, shall I light the tree?
Well, we've had the light thrown on us. Let's light up the tree.
Merry Christmas, Throckmorton.
Merry Christmas, Irene. And all you would-be Santa Clauses. There's Gildersleeve again, friends. You know, we have a lot of fun all during the year, and we hope we're able to pass some of it on to you. But I suppose Christmas time is the nicest time of the year, full of gaiety and good cheer, a time for friendliness and peace. All of us who bring you this show, the men and women at Kraft, the entire Gildersleeve cast, and myself, wish you a holiday season filled with all these things. A very Merry Christmas from all of us to all of you.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive the King. Let every heart prepare His room. Let heaven and nature see. Let heaven and nature see.
Transcribed. Here you bet your life with Groucho Marx on the NBC Radio Network.
Now play You Bet Your Life with Groucho on the NBC Radio Network.
The Kraft Foods Company presents Willard Waterman as the Great Gildersleeve. The Great Gildersleeve is brought to you, transcribed, by the Kraft Foods Company. Kraft, makers and importers of the world's favorite cheese, now brings you a triumph of cheese making. It's Kraft Natural Swiss Cheese, sliced and sealed by Kraft for your convenience. Natural Swiss cheese is the kind with the holes. Try Kraft Natural Swiss soon. We're sure this new addition to the Kraft family of quality foods will become one of your all-time favorites.
Gildersleeve coming down the street on his way home from the office. He'll be hungry as usual, and Bertie's going to have everything he likes for dinner. You know why? It's not long till...
Before the kids come, shall I light the tree?
Well, we've had the light thrown on us. Let's light up the tree.
Merry Christmas, Throckmorton.
Merry Christmas, Irene. And all you would-be Santa Clauses. There's Gildersleeve again, friends. You know, we have a lot of fun all during the year, and we hope we're able to pass some of it on to you. But I suppose Christmas time is the nicest time of the year, full of gaiety and good cheer, a time for friendliness and peace. All of us who bring you this show, the men and women at Kraft, the entire Gildersleeve cast, and myself, wish you a holiday season filled with all these things. A very Merry Christmas from all of us to all of you. Well, why shouldn't I? I made it a Jolly Boys project. Now, I sold the trees. Why shouldn't I pass out the presents?
Oh, you've done too much, Mr. Gildersleeve. I think it's time I got on the job.
What do you mean?
I'd like to donate my services and be Santa Claus.
Peavy, you don't look like a Santa Claus.
I do to Mrs. Peavy. She considered me a very convincing Santa Claus.
Well, she's prejudiced. You're not big enough for Santa Claus.
Well, I can tie on a couple of pillows. I'd rather wear them at Christmas than to have to carry them around all year like you do.
Now, wait a minute, fellas. Why don't we arbitrate this thing? I'll be Santa Claus.
Chief, that's not the way you arbitrate.
But Santa's supposed to be a jolly fellow. I've got the voice for it.
Oh, brother.
You sound like a walrus lost in the fog.
Well, if the chief of police can't play Santa Claus to those kids, you fellas better not run afoul of the law next year.
No, fiddlesticks. Let's not have a Santa Claus if it's going to cause an uproar.
No Santa Claus?
I think Peavy has a good idea.
Well, all right, all right. I'll call Olson and tell him we've all agreed not to have a Santa Claus. What do you say, fellas?
In the interest of harmony... No Santa Claus.
No Santa Claus.
No Santa Claus.
Buddy?
Well, in this day and age, certainly, under the circumstances.
Will you take me, Mr. Gildersleeve?
Me?
Oh, if you take me to that party, I could get my boyfriend back.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Bessie, but Friday night's out of the question.
If my boyfriend could see me with you, he'd be so jealous.
Oh, Bessie. He would?
Because you're so... so handsome and distinguished looking.
If you think that'll be a help to you.
Oh, yes, sir. And if you'll take me to that party, I'm sure my work will improve around the office.
Bessie, that sold me. Yes, Bertie.
You home from the office?
Yeah, I believe I am.
Sure you are, because I see you.
Hi, Unc, you home?
My boy, what does it look like?
Looks like you're home.
Yes, yes. Bertie.
Yes, sir?
Will you take my tuxedo out of the mothballs and get it in shape for me to wear Friday night?
Yes, sir.
Going somewhere, Unc?
Of course I'm going somewhere. Don't be so curious.
Who's curious? Where are you going?
I'm going to the Elks Club's dance.
Watch it, Olson.
Give me the bankroll, Gildersleeve. I'll go buy presents for all the kids.
You keep your sterilized pinkies off my money.
All right. You buy the gifts, and I'll present them at the tree.
You'll present them?
Well, I was to play Santa Claus, wasn't I, Irene?
Well...
Look, Olson, I'll be Santa Claus.
But, Gildersleeve, you've done so much. You told us that yourself.
You bet. And after I've knocked the home run, you aren't going to pose for the picture.
Now, please, boys.
I volunteered to help Irene raise money for her Christmas party long before you and the Jolly Boys came in.
Well, when I came in, you went out.
I won't argue with you, but I'll be Santa Claus.
Oh, for...
Hey, Unc, I sold another tree.
Good for you, my boy.
Wonderful, Leroy.
Yeah. Unc, hadn't we better connect the lights?
Well, I haven't quite figured out how to attach the wires to the switch.
Oh, I'll do that, Gildersleeve. I undoubtedly understand wiring better than you.
Shouldn't you call an electrician?
No, Irene, I can do it.
Hands off, Olson, I'll do it.
Well, I wouldn't do it while standing in that slushy snow.
When I need advice from you...
The Christmas tree lot's a big success, Bertie.
I sure am glad.
Well, it was planning, organization, know-how.
Yes, sir.
Speaking of know-how, you should have seen Uncle when he tried to connect the lights on the...
Natural Swiss soon. We're sure this new addition to the Kraft family of quality foods will become one of your all-time favorites.
Well, I see Mr. Gildersleeve coming down the street on his way home from the office. He'll be hungry as usual, and Bertie's going to have everything he likes for dinner. You know why? It's not long till Christmas. I hope Mr. Gildersleeve notices the holly wreath I put on the door.
Hello, Bertie.
Hey, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Say, that's a nice wreath you've got on the door. Looks real Christmassy.
Thank you, sir. Glad you noticed it.
Yeah, well, I couldn't miss it with the arrow pointing to it.
No, sir.
I put up the arrow, Unc.
Yeah, hello, Leroy.
Hi. I just wanted everybody around here to know Christmas is coming.
Yeah, I'm well aware of it, my boy.
Oh, here, let me take your hat and coat.
Yeah.
Leroy, you take his hat and I'll take his coat.
Okay.
Such service.
Yes, sir. And I'll brush it off before I hang it up.
Unc, you need a shine. Here, let me brush off your shoes.
If you're so anxious, I'll take them off and you can give them a real shine.
Anything you say, Unc.
I'll run up and get your house slippers, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Don't trouble yourself, Bertie.
No trouble at all. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Well, I wouldn't stoop to such obvious tactics.
Oh, no, sir.
But maybe I should go over to Irene's this evening and offer to help before Olson bungles it.
Yes, sir. I think you should get into a huddle with her, too.
I thought I was a little jealous of that curly-haired intern. Well, maybe I am.
Hello, Throckmorton. Come in.
Yeah, thank you, Irene.
Let me take your hat and coat.
Yeah, I'll just put them right here in the chair. That way, you and I'll have to sit on the couch.
Oh, you're quite a schemer, aren't you?
You bet. Yeah. I tried to get you on the phone today.
Oh?
Leroy tells me you're having a big Christmas party for the kids.
Yes, I thought it might be nice.
Yeah, I'm a little hurt because you didn't ask me to help.
I'm sorry, Throckmorton. Clarence Olson volunteered first, and I know you're a beau who doesn't like to play second fiddle.
Of course, I don't want to say anything against Olson, but this is a job for a businessman.
Yes, I realize it'll take a lot of...
George, I sure made a hit with Irene. She likes an executive-type fellow who gets things done. Well, I better stop in Peavy's and start telling the Jolly Boys the plans I've made for them. I'll have to assign them certain days to work on the lot. Hello, Peavy.
Yeah, hello, Mr. Gildersleeve. What can I do for you?
Peavy, I want to talk to you.
If all you want to do is talk, I'll just keep on with what I'm doing.
So I was just talking to Irene Henshaw.
6 and 2 are 8 and 3 are 11.
Peavy, what are you doing?
I'm making out my bank deposit slip. 3, 7 and 10.
Can't that wait?
Mr. Gildersleeve, do you want to buy something?
No.
I'm dealing with people who have bought something. 3, 14 and 3, 17, $187.
Peavy, listen to me. That isn't important.
Do you have anything to say that's worth $187?
Oh, my goodness. Look, I have a great idea.
You don't say.
Yes, indeed. The Jolly Boys are going to sell Christmas trees to raise money.
Well, we can use it. We've got $2.69 in the treasury.
Peavy, we're going to spend this money on the kids.
Suits me. I'm a bigger kid as anybody around Christmas time.
Yes, yes.
I got the Christmas spirit this morning. Before I left for the pharmacy, I chucked Mrs. Peavy under the chin. She said I was a big overgrown kid.
I hope Mr. Gilsteve notices the holly wreath I put on the door.
Hello, Bertie.
Hey, Miss Gilsteve.
Say, that's a nice wreath you've got on the door. Looks real Christmassy.
Thank you, sir. Glad you noticed it.
Yeah, well, I couldn't miss it with the arrow pointing to it.
No, sir.
I put up the arrow on.
Yeah, hello, Leroy.
Hi. I just wanted everybody around here to know Christmas is coming.
Yeah, I'm well aware of it, my boy.
Oh, here, let me take your hat and coat.
Yeah.
Leroy, you take his hat and I'll take his coat.
Okay.
Such service.
Yes, sir. And I'll brush it off before I hang it up.
Unc, you need a shine. Here, let me brush off your shoes.
If you're so anxious, I'll take them off and you can give them a real shine.
Anything you say, Unc.
I'll run up and get your house slippers, Mr. Gilsteve.
Don't trouble yourself, Bertie.
No trouble at all. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Bertie can't wait for Santa Claus to come and unload his sleigh. Hey!
Oh, my goodness.
Here's the evening paper, Unc. You can read it while I'm shining your shoes.
Yeah, thank you.
There are some wonderful gift suggestions in the paper this evening.
Maybe I shouldn't read it. I'll just sit here and read the handwriting on the wall.
Have you written your letter to Santa yet, Unc? Mention anything you want within reason.
What's within reason? A dollar?
We want everybody to have just what they want around here, you know.
Yeah. The way to do this is to get the Jolly Boys to back me up. After all, it has become a Jolly Boys project. Olsen has nothing to do with it. Hello, Peavy.
Oh, hello, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Hello, Chief.
Hello, Commissioner. We were over at the lot last night, but there were no trees left to sell.
Well, I did a good job, if I do say so myself.
What's the meeting about, Mr. Gildersleeve?
As you fellas know, I took this out of Olsen's hands and raised the money for the guests myself. Now, guess who wants to be Santa Claus?
You?
Well, why shouldn't I? I made it a Jolly Boys project. Now, I sold the trees. Why shouldn't I pass out the presents?
Oh, you've done too much, Mr. Gildersleeve. I think it's time I got on the job.
What do you mean?
I'd like to donate my services and be Santa Claus.
Peavy, you don't look like a Santa Claus.
I do to Mrs. Peavy. She considers me a very convincing Santa Claus.
Well, she's prejudiced. You're not big enough for Santa Claus.
Well, I can tie on a couple of pillows. I'd rather wear them at Christmas than to have to carry them around all year like you do.
Now, wait a minute, fellas. Why don't we arbitrate this thing? I'll be Santa Claus.
Chief, that's not the way you arbitrate.
But Santa's supposed to be a jolly fellow. I've got the voice for it.
Oh. Waiting for somebody across the street.
Looks like the judge has painted his house.
Yeah. New doorbell, too.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Hey, a butler.
Won't you come in?
Does Judge Hooker still live here?
Oh, yes, sir. He's expecting you, isn't he?
Well...
Who's that?
Hello, Judge.
Well, Gilday and Leroy.
Hi, Judge.
What a surprise.
Yes, it is. In a way.
Won't you come in a moment?
Is it okay if we do?
Leroy, you're always welcome. Don't stand there, Gilda. Come in.
Well, only for a moment.
May I take your hat, sir?
No, thank you. I'll just hold it.
I'll take care of my old friends, Albert.
Very good, sir.
You have a butler now, Horace?
Oh, he's from the caterers, Gilda. I have him when I entertain.
How about that?
I didn't think you had a regular butler. Nor a car and chauffeur?
Oh, no, that belongs to one of my guests. I'm having a party, Gilda.
Oh, well, then we'd better be on our way.
No, not yet. Come into the parlor. I want you to meet one of the early arrivals, my good friend and client, Mr. W. Roxwell Logan.
Well...
Mr. Logan, this is Mr. Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve.
Yeah, how do you do, Mr. Logan?
How do you do? What did you say your name was?
Gildersleeve.
Oh, I thought...
locked this week.
Well, to tell you the truth, I've got Santa Claus locked up in there. I want to be sure he stops here first.
Yes, sir?
Is he in that big red box in the corner, or is he under your bed with all those other packages?
Young man, how do you know what's in my room?
I shinnied up the big tree by your window and looked in.
Leroy.
Leroy and I are really looking forward to Christmas, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Did you shinny up the tree too, Bertie?
No, sir, not me. I don't know what's in that room. I can't even get in there with the vacuum cleaner.
Well, the room will be cleaned out after Christmas. And so will I.
Yes.
Hey, Aunt, guess what your girl is going to do at school?
Yeah, I don't know. And I'll thank you not to refer to Miss Henshaw as my girl.
Okay. Sweetie?
Leroy. She's your school principal.
Okay, okay.
Well, what's she going to do, Leroy?
She's going to have a tree in the gymnasium with presents for all the needy kids in town.
Yo?
That's nice.
Yeah, some of us kids are going to help collect presents.
I tried to get Irene on the phone all day. Figured she was busy with something.
Yeah, she and Dr. Olson have been busy, all right.
Dr. Olson?
He's been huddling with her all day.
Uh-oh.
What does that pushy intern have to do with it?
Oh, he just offered to help her arrange everything. She has to rustle up a lot of gifts somehow.
This might turn out to be fun.
Judge Hooker speaking.
Judge, this is Mr. Peavy.
Well, hello, Peavy.
I thought you might like to attend a special Jolly Boys meeting tonight.
I can't make it. I'd rather not see Gildy.
Judge, all the members won't be there.
Oh?
We can do without a certain big blowhard. Catch on, Judge?
Yes, I do.
I've been thinking over some of the things you said about a certain city official, and perhaps we should just tell him to go peddle his water.
You mean blackball, Gilder?
Well, do you have any other suggestions for getting rid of him that are legal?
Well, it is the Yuletide season.
I don't get sentimental, Judge. Are you coming to the meeting or not?
I'll be there.
Yeah, there's a light on upstairs. Some of the Jolly Boys are here already. I don't hear any singing. Well, when you're blackballing somebody, it's no time to sing.
Is that you, Peavy?
Hello. Something went haywire.
Who is it?
Nosy old judge. You can't even keep him away from the meeting you're throwing him out of.
Gildy, what are you doing?
It's just because it's Christmas. He's catering to Irene. Just trying to cut me out.
Are you jealous, Unc?
Most certainly not. But what does Clarence Olson know about organizing a thing like this? He's not a businessman. He's just an intern studying to be a surgeon.
He's got this operation sewed up.
Well, I wouldn't stoop to such obvious tactics.
Oh, no, sir.
But maybe I should go over to Irene's this evening and offer to help before Olson bungles it.
Yes, sir. I think you should get into a huddle with it, too.
Bertie and Leroy thought I was a little jealous of that curly-haired intern. Well, maybe I am.
Hello, Throckmorton. Come in.
Thank you, Irene.
Let me take your hat and coat.
I'll just put him right here in the chair. That way, you and I'll have to sit on the couch.
Oh, you're quite a schemer, aren't you?
You bet. Yeah. I tried to get you on the phone today.
Oh?
Leroy tells me you're having a big Christmas party for the kids.
Yes, I thought it might be nice.
Yeah, I'm a little hurt because you didn't ask me to help.
Found a good place where I can buy it wholesale.
Where, Peavy?
Peavy's Pharmacy.
Yes, yes.
What are you getting Mrs. Peavy this year? Are you just taking something home from the pharmacy?
Oh, no. As a matter of fact, Mrs. Peavy and I put a lot of thought into our gifts.
You do?
I spent a lot of time and money on Mrs. Peavy's this year, and she's going to be very happy.
What are you giving her?
A new furnace.
A furnace?
Yeah, I thought that was a hot idea.
Oh.
Yeah, Mrs. Peavy and I like to be practical about our gifts.
What's she giving you?
The coal to burn in it.
That's ridiculous.
Mr. Gildersleeve, are you getting a 2-ton present from anybody?
Well, I hope not. I'd rather end up with a lot of Hawaiian sunset neckties like you and the judge always give me.
You know, I haven't seen the judge since the last Jolly Boys meeting.
You know, I wasn't there that night. Yeah, I haven't seen him in months. Well, I got a Christmas card from him yesterday, Petey.
You don't say?
Yeah.
I haven't received mine yet. The judge usually drops it by the pharmacy to save the postage.
No, Peavy, let's not say anything against the judge.
Well, I'm not saying anything against him.
Yeah, I feel a little guilty about losing touch with Horace. I guess I've grown away from him a little bit.
Well, you've been busy.
Yeah, I've made new friends. I seem to be traveling in another circle.
You've been...
What goes into your favorite sandwich? Maybe it's roast beef or savory baked ham. Whatever your favorite, the perfect meat sandwich needs the perfect mustard. Kraft prepared mustard. For when you add a little mustard, you add a lot of tang. You can take your choice of two kinds of Kraft mustard. Mild Kraft mustard is smooth and delicately spiced. Or if you like your mustard with extra pep, try Kraft mustard with snappy horseradish added. Keep them both on hand and keep everyone in the family happy. Next time, get Kraft prepared mustard.
The holiday season from Christmas to New Year's is an especially deadly period so far as traffic accidents are concerned. The toll of traffic fatalities rises sharply every year during this period. Please take extra precautions in walking and driving. Don't let death take your holiday. Now play You Bet Your Life with Groucho on the NBC Radio Network.
The Kraft Foods Company, makers of parquet margarine, presents Willard Waterman as the Great Gildersleeve.
And sealed by Kraft for your convenience. Natural Swiss cheese is the kind with the holes. Try Kraft Natural Swiss soon. We're sure this new addition to the Kraft family of quality foods will become one of your all-time favorites.
Well, I see Mr. Gildersleeve coming down the street on his way home from the office. He'll be hungry as usual, and Bertie's going to have everything he likes for dinner. You know why? It's not long till Christmas. I hope Mr. Gildersleeve notices the holly wreath I put on the door.
Hello, Bertie.
Hey, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Say, that's a nice wreath you've got on the door. Looks real Christmassy.
Thank you, sir. Glad you noticed it.
Well, I couldn't miss it with the arrow pointing to it.
No, sir.
I put up the arrow, Unc.
Yeah, hello, Leroy.
Hi. I just wanted everybody around here to know Christmas is coming.
Yeah, I'm well aware of it, my boy.
Oh, here, let me take your hat and coat.
Yeah.
Leroy, you take his hat and I'll take his coat.
Okay.
Such service.
Yes, sir. And I'll brush it off before I hang it up.
Unc, you need a shine. Here, let me brush off your shoes.
If you're so anxious, I'll take them off and you can give them a real shine.
Anything you say, Unc.
I'll run up and get your house slippers, Mr. Gildersleeve.
You don't trouble yourself.
some customers, Throckmorton.
Heck, I'm going to start selling. Christmas trees? Right this way for your Christmas trees.
Yeah, look at them pick out their trees. Why, George, the old world seems pretty uncooperative at times. But when you try to do something good, a lot of people get behind you. Pick out their trees. Why, George, the old world seems pretty uncooperative at times. But when you try to do something good, a lot of people get behind you.
Fellas, why don't we arbitrate this thing? I'll be Santa Claus.
Chief, that's not the way you arbitrate.
But Santa's supposed to be a jolly fellow. I've got the voice for it.
Oh, brother.
Chief, you sound like a walrus lost in the fog.
Well, if the chief of police can't play Santa Claus to those kids, you fellas better not run afoul of the law next year.
No, fiddlesticks. Let's not have a Santa Claus if it's going to cause an uproar.
No Santa Claus?
I think Peavy has a good idea.
Well, all right, all right. I'll call Olson and tell him we've all agreed not to have a Santa Claus. What do you say, fellas?
In the interest of harmony, no Santa Claus.
No Santa Claus.
No Santa Claus. They don't know I have my fingers crossed. Yeah, I'll slip in the back door of the gym so nobody will see me.
Is that you, Unc?
Yep, old Santa in person.
I thought you fellas weren't having a Santa.
Well, I couldn't disappoint a bunch of kids just because we adults had a squabble. Leroy, how did you know me in this Santa suit?
You're the only knock-kneed Santa in town.
Young man.
You man.
Yeah, now, if I can get you out the door.
I've never been carried across the threshold. I always thought I'd be going the other way.
You're too heavy. You'll have to walk.
Oh, wow.
Come into the office, Irene.
All right, all right.
Oh, hello, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Hello, Bessie.
You're awfully late this morning. It's lunchtime.
Bessie, I was forced to go to Miss Henshaw's and bring her here to the office.
Wouldn't she pay your water bill?
I'm paid up, Miss Barstow. I'm fed up, too.
Bessie, tell Miss Henshaw why you asked me to take you to the dance. Now, admit everything.
Everything?
Tell her about your boyfriend.
Well, I had a boyfriend, but he had another engagement last night.
Another engagement?
Yes, sir. To be married.
Oh, my goodness.
I read about it in this morning's paper.
Oh, you poor dear.
It was so nice of you to take me to the dance, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Well, that's all right, Bessie. I'm sorry you no longer have a boyfriend.
Oh, I have another boyfriend now.
You have?
Oh, yes, here he is to take me to lunch.
Ready, Bessie? Uh-oh.
Dr. Olson, you remember Miss Henshaw and Mr. Gildersleeve?
Clarence.
Hello.
Gildersleeve, are you getting a 2-ton present from anybody?
Well, I hope not. I'd rather end up with a lot of Hawaiian sunset neckties like you and the judge always give me.
You know, I haven't seen the judge since the last Johnny Boys meeting.
You know, I wasn't there that night. Yeah, I haven't seen him in months. Well, I got a Christmas card from him yesterday, Petey.
You don't say?
Yeah.
I haven't received mine yet. The judge usually drops it by the pharmacy to save the postage.
No, Peavy, let's not say anything against the judge.
No, I'm not saying anything against him.
Yeah, you know, I feel a little guilty about losing touch with Horace. I guess I've grown away from him a little bit.
Well, you've been busy.
Yeah, I've made new friends. I seem to be traveling in another circle.
You've been going around in circles, all right.
You're all right, Peavy. The point is, I have to watch it. Well, I'm forging ahead. I shouldn't leave old friends like the judge by the wayside.
I don't know what the judge is doing these days.
Well, I'm going over this evening to make a duty call. Cheer him up. You want to come along, Peavy?
No, I have to go home to Mrs. Peavy.
Well, she wouldn't care if you stayed out with the boys one night, would she?
No, I wouldn't care that.
Christmas spirit is a wonderful thing to have, Leroy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can see already that one of the greatest joys I'll have...
Me?
Oh, if you take me to that party, I could get my boyfriend back.
Yeah, sorry, Bessie, but Friday night's out of the question.
If my boyfriend could see me with you, he'd be so jealous.
Oh, Bessie. He would?
Because you're so handsome and distinguished looking.
If you think that'll be a help to you.
Oh, yes, sir. And if you'll take me to that party, I'm sure my work will improve around the office.
Bessie, that sold me.
That you, Miss Gilfie?
Yes, Bertie.
You home from the office?
Yeah, I believe I am.
Sure you are, because I see you. Hi, Unc, you home?
My boy, what does it look like?
Looks like you're home.
Yes, yes. Bertie.
Yes, sir?
Will you take my tuxedo out of the mothballs and get it in shape for me to wear Friday night?
Yes, sir.
Going somewhere, Unc?
Of course I'm going somewhere. Don't be so curious.
Who's curious? Where are you going?
I'm going to the Elks Club's dance.
Hey, you going to wear your Elks tooth with your tuxedo?
No, Leroy, if I...
Everybody's asked for it, going to get it.
Goodbye, baby.
Goodbye. This might turn out to be fun.
Judge Hooker's, Peggy.
Judge, this is Mr. Peavy.
Well, hello, Peavy.
I thought you might like to attend a special Jolly Boys meeting tonight.
I can't make it. I'd rather not see Gildy.
Judge, all the members won't be there.
Oh?
We can do without a certain big blowhard. Catch on, Judge?
Yes, I do.
I've been thinking over some of the things you said about a certain city official, and perhaps we should just tell him to go peddle his water.
You mean blackball,
Gilder? Well, do you have any other suggestions for getting rid of him that are legal?
Well, it is the Yuletide season.
And I don't get sentimental, Judge. Are you coming to the meeting or not?
I'll be there.
Yeah, there's a light on upstairs. Some of the Jolly Boys are here already. I don't hear any singing. Well, when you're blackballing somebody, it's no time to sing.
Is that you, Peavy?
Hello. Something went haywire.
Who is it?
Nosy old judge. You can't even keep him away from the meeting.